Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingle all the way. Oh, what fun it is to ride in a one-horse open.
My father loved Christmas, and even though he was a Jewish communist, in fact, because he was a Jewish communist, because Jesus was a great Jewish communist, according to my father. So, and also Santa Claus was this example of redistributing the toys equally around the world, just based on good morals.
Right.
So, and the elves were unionized, as far as we can tell. So, by the Wobblies. So, so it was all a really wonderful package, but. My father and my mother were always kind of jockeying for who were the truth tellers, and since they were both ideologically the same, they're both communists, they were divorced, you see. My mother had just told me, was continuing to tell me that Santa Claus was real, and I was like six or so. So my father decided that he was going to be a good communist father and tell me that Santa Claus wasn't real.
Okay.
Except when he told me that, I burst into tears. I was like, just miserable.
All right.
And so my father, and we were taking the train up, and my father was, you know, thinking on his feet at that point, and he realized that he had to come up with a counter story, like a new story to cover that. Because I was saying, well, Daddy, if there's no Santa Claus, then who distributes the toys to all the boys and girls of the world? So my father stalled, and then he finally said this. He said, you know the department store S. Klein's. Were you familiar with that? Do you remember? You might be too young for that.
Only the name is familiar.
Yes, it was the initial S, last name Klein's.
Right.
It was high discounts there. Okay. He said the
delivery... Oh, yeah.
Yeah, right. Do you remember that? It was in Union Square.
Right.
He said the delivery man from S. Klein's puts all the toys in his delivery truck and he takes it all around the world.
Wow.
To all the children who've been good.
Right.
And presumably not fascists.
Right.
Or even really heavy-duty capitalists. Right.
Right.
So my father told me this story, and as it happened, he may have even thought of that because where we changed from the subway to the bus at Union Square was in front of S. Klein's department store. Now, coincidentally, as he was telling me this, there were a bunch of the members of this gang called the Royal Bishops who were loitering in the doorway of S. Klein's. My father knew them because he was their social worker. My father was a social worker with New York City, and his thing was to try to get them to stop being criminals and fighting and stuff, which gangs apparently like to do.
Okay.
Yeah, and possibly some drugs and things like that. Although, actually, I don't think they did drugs. Yeah. Okay. So anyhow, he had gotten them jobs, seasonal jobs at S. Klein's, so that they would not be criminals.
Right.
And here they were loitering. So my father was very upset because he was really in danger of losing his job because he hadn't been very successful as their social worker. So he said, come on, go back inside, everyone. Go, you know. And they sort of mollified him. He said, don't worry, Paul, we're just taking a break. We're working hard. We'll you know, you can trust us. We're you know.
Right.
And so they went back in. And the two leaders, by the way, of the Royal Bishops were Johnny Lubell and Tony Little Tiger Lopez.
Okay.
And there's also a bald guy named Mr. Clean who did the guns.
Okay.
And so I loved them. They were just really, to me, really sweet and fun.
Right.
So anyhow, now I was feeling great.
Mr. Clean bald?
Mr. Clean was bald. That's why he was nicknamed Mr. Clean.
All right.
Right. So here we... So now I was fine, right? Now it's Christmas Eve. Okay, I lost this story about Santa Claus, but that's for little kids.
Right.
Now I have the real story, which is the delivery man from S.
You have the true myth.
I have the true one. But to me, it was totally true. And we saw some of my favorite people who were the guys from, you know...
Yeah.
From the gang, from the Royal Bishops. So that night, as I always
said... Which confirmed everything.
It all fit together.
Right, exactly.
It was all part of the world that my dad presided over.
Right. Get back to work and go deliver those
Go
toys.
Deliver, right. Well, yes, because the workers, it's the workers who will inherit the earth.
Exactly.
So it's not the loiterers.
Right,
okay. So we went back to East 7th Street between C and D, where we lived, as we were talking about, where you lived somewhere around there until you recently relocated.
13th and B.
You were 13th and B. We were on 7th between C and D. And that night, as always, my dad tucked me in Christmas Eve, and I was determined to stay up. And now this time, not here, Santa Claus in his sleigh, but actually with, you know, the jingle bells.
Right.
But in fact, I knew better now.
Spot the delivery truck.
The delivery truck, like the rumble of the delivery truck. So I was listening for that, and at some point, as always, I fell asleep. But I think my father didn't expect me to get up as early as I did. Because when I got up and went out into the front, I would say front room, but except there isn't really a front room because it was one room, right? But basically, when I went out to the front where the tree was, there were no gifts because my father hadn't expected me to get up that early.
Right.
And so here I was, and now all of a sudden, what was he going to do? I start crying. My father wakes up. He comes out. He can't show me that he's been hiding the gifts under the bench, you know. So what's he going to do? And he was stuck, except at that moment, there was this, not a jingling, but a sort of a tinkling sound that came from around Avenue D. And so I opened the window. We were on the second floor, and I looked out, and coming around the corner, pushing this... this rack of brand new ladies' pantsuits from S. Klein's department store was a member of the Royal Bishops. And then behind him, another member of the Royal Bishops also pushing. And in fact, it was all the Royal Bishops, and they had toys and big bins, and they had racks of clothing, and they were pushing them all down the street. And Tony Little Tiger Lopez and Johnny Lubell had their Santa caps on, and they were saying, ho, 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 Merry Christmas. And you know, our neighborhood, as we were talking about earlier, was quite poor.
Right.
And so here was something, they were literally throwing gifts. They were throwing clothing, ladies and men's clothing and toys. They're throwing them. And they saw me and said, hey, Joshy, ho, ho, ho. And Johnny Lubell, I think it was, he grabbed the bottom of our... you know, the ladder from the
fire escape,
and he climbed up with a sack of toys, and he handed it to me. And I said to my dad, Dad, you could have been more specific. You just said it was the delivery man from S. Klein's. You could have told me it was Johnny Lubell and Tony Little Tiger Lopez. And I think at that point, my father was, I think he was left with this, if I'm looking back on it now as an adult,
right.
I'm thinking he must have been so conflicted at that moment. Because on the one hand, he must have known then he had just lost his job as a social worker. He'd gotten jobs for all the members of the Royal Bishops. And they'd all stolen. They'd stolen the entire inventory. So that was on the negative side. But on the positive side, the story he had told me had proved to be correct.
It's a true story.
And so the lesson really ultimately was that I guess, maybe, is that as messed up as you might be, and as much as you might be improvising, that if you have faith and hope, the magic will happen.
Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad.
Okay, thanks.
Feliz Navidad, prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad, Feliz Navidad.